Narito yung parents ko. So they sponsored me, and that was like 1991. Alam mo, dito sa Canada, it's really hard to start, right? You know, so nung dumating ako rito, una ako nagtrabaho sa McDonald's. I work as a night maintenance for 6 months. And then fortunately, this hotel here in downtown, the Fairmont Waterfront, they opened, and then I was one of the pioneers, so to speak, to be hired. And I started working at the Fairmont since 1991, and it's been almost 25 years now. It's still doing the same job, and I'm kind of liking it. I'm happy with it. It's hard though, waking up early in the morning. I live in Surrey, which is like 40 minutes from downtown, so I have to leave home like 6:20 in the morning, get here like 7:20, and then start work at 7:30. Yeah, so araw-araw ganyan, Monday to Friday. Saturday and Sunday, day off ko naman, so I have to spend time with my family. I think I'm one of the lucky one na wala akong masyadong hirap, you know, kasi during that time bibihira pa yung mga ano eh, mga kukunti pa lang yung mga Pilipino. Right, so and they want diversity in the hotel. They want to have different kinds of cultures working for them. And I think that's one of the advantages that I have. English is not your main language, right? So kuminsan may mga communication difficulties ka na encounter, na kuminsan iba yung pronunciation mo. But they understand you anyways. Nung in-sponsoran ako ng parents ko, single pa ako noon. Kasi when they were sponsored by my sister, silang dalawa ng mother ko at saka yung mga kapatid ko na below 21. During that time, I'm already overage. But my dad told me not to get married in the Philippines. Kasi sabi niya baka magkaroon ka pa ng chance later on. And it did. Lumabas yung bagong law ng Canada na pwede sila mag-sponsor ng naiwan nilang anak doon, provided na binata. Doon ako nakapasok. So, ang nag-sponsor talaga sa akin yung father ko with the help of my brother-in-law. After 10 months, I decided to sponsor my girlfriend kasi magkasama na kami sa Pilipinas noon. We've been together for 10 years. And sana nag-asawa na ako kung hindi dahil sa ano ng father ko na huwag mag-asawa. Kasi gusto ko rin makapunta ng Canada, right? So, dito na kami nagpakasal kasi requirement yun ng immigration na I have to get married with my girlfriend within 3 months upon arrival niya. Or else, pauuwiin din siya. So, I have to get married. So far, so good. We've been together for 23 years. May dalawa kaming anak. Isang babae, which is 21 now. And then yung lalaki ko is 19. And they're both taking up nursing. Why? They love us. They love the Filipinos kasi mga Filipino are hardworking, right? So they love the Filipinos, and then they like our pagtatrabaho natin. Where Filipinos are hardworking, and they like that. And ang Canada kasi multicultural din eh. So they like other people from different countries to be integrated in the society, right? So they like the Filipinos. Napakaganda yung pag-ano niya, pagbibisita niya rito para mapalakas niya yung bilateral relationship niya sa Canada, between the Philippines and Canada, at saka mabigyan niya rin ng pansin yung mga overseas Filipino workers here in Vancouver na baka mayroong mga konting problema. But I'm happy for him, and I hope he's gonna continue to do what he's doing right now, yung matuwid na daan, no? Kasi that's the only way na mapagpaano niya yung ekonomiya ng Pilipinas, get rid of the corrupt officials back home, right? That's the only way for him, and I'm very happy for him. So, Mr. President, just continue what you're doing. May God bless you.